On May 29th, 1453, the troops of the Muslim leader Mehmed II conquered the great city of Constantinople, New Rome. For more than 1,100 years, Greek Orthodox Christians had assumed that the Greek Orthodox Christian Roman Empire would stand until the second coming of Christ. They had always called their city the God-protected city. And indeed, until now, it had been protected by heaven. But when the Roman Emperor, Constantine XI, fell in battle, New Rome became the capital of a new empire, the Ottoman Empire, ruled by a pagan people, enemies of Christ and Christianity, the Muslims. It was a dark, dark time for Orthodox Christians. In their violent hatred of Christianity, the Muslim Turks embarked on a course of persecution designed to effectively enslave the flock of Christ. Their strategy was no less cruel than that of atheist communists in the Soviet Union. To the Turks, the Romans were infidels, and they had absolutely no rights of citizenship. They even had to wear distinctive dress. They could not marry Muslims, nor could they engage in missionary work of any kind. In fact, it was a crime punishable by death to convert a Muslim to the Christian faith. There were many rewards given to those Christians who would convert to the Muslim religion. Often, these enticements worked, and many Orthodox Christians gave up the struggle and betrayed their true faith in Christ. The majority of the sultans were sick, demon-ridden men whose irrational rule and unbridled power only heightened the already demoralizing effect of Turkish rule on the church. The aim of Orthodoxy in the Ottoman Empire became, simply, one of survival. Little could they know, in 1453, that the heavy sword of Islam would weigh upon them, not for a generation or two, but for five long centuries of darkness. When Mehmed had entered the city, he was heard stating, "Now, at this joyful moment of time, we have the riches of the Romans. We have won their empire, and their religion is completely extinguished." But Mehmed greatly underestimated the omnipotence of Jesus Christ and the faith in him of the Orthodox Christian Romans. He was proven very wrong through the courageous confession of the new martyrs of the Turkish yoke.
In commemorating the lives and struggles of the holy new martyrs who suffered for the sake of Christ's holy name, we give thanks to our God, who is worshiped in Trinity, and who in every age has raised up witnesses to his eternal providence and care for us. God is marvelous in his saints. The saints are living proof of the applicability of the Gospels. They're living chapters of Holy Scripture. They're imitators of Christ and models of our emulation. This is the reason that God has glorified the saints in our sight. In his love for us, he wants to present us as many different kinds of righteous ones as possible so that we, regardless of our circumstance in life, might find patterns to live the life in Christ. The first and most glorious of martyrs is Jesus our Lord, whose blood nourishes the members of his holy body, the church. In his loving kindness, he has deemed some others worthy to be images and icons of his unique martyrdom, and to spill their blood for the sake of the Holy Gospel, as a living witness and renewal for Christians who, seeing the steadfastness of their fellow mortals in the face of torture and death, might themselves become more fervent in the faith. During the dark days of the Muslim enslavement of the Orthodox people in the Balkans and the Middle East, our holy faith showed its power in the face of the overwhelming force of the Turk. All the vital forces of Orthodoxy continued unabated. Monasticism flourished, theological conscience was alert, popular devotion was cultivated. All of these fueled and nourished by the feats of the illustrious new martyrs, who brought to life before the grateful eyes of the oppressed Christians scenes of the martyrdoms of old, assuring them that indeed, Christ is the same yesterday and today and unto the ages of ages. It is this eternal contemporariness of the martyrs that makes a collection of lives such as this so important for us today. More than just a historical review of the martyrs for Christ in a particular time and place, these lives permit us to see a continuity, a golden chain which links together the Christ-centered glories of the ancient martyrs with those of the Turkish domination and onto those of China, Serbia, the Balkans, and under the Russian land under the more modern, but nonetheless demonic, hatred of militant atheism. And what is the future? Despite our unworthiness of the martyr's crown, will our Lord vouchsafe this greatest of blessings on Christians of our generation or of those to come? As we progress into this post-Christian era, which is an introduction to the times of the Antichrist, will there be new martyrs from the United States? Through the fervent prayers of thy holy new martyrs, O Christ our God, preserve and strengthen thy Orthodox people through the fiery trial to come. Amen.
Nei martires palean planin, καταστρέψαντες ύψωσαν πίστην, των ορθοδόξων και στερός υγονίστησαν, την γαρανόμων θρησκείαν ελέξαντες, εν παρησία Χριστόν ανεκήρυξαν. Θεόν τέλειον και νυν απάστος πρεσβεύουσι, δωρήσαστε ημίν το μεγάλο.